10 Cats Does Countdown. Sean Locke, John Richardson, Kathy Burke, David Bedil, Alex Horn and the Horn Section, Susie Dent, and Rachel Riley. Now, welcome your host, Jimmy.
To the AR 10 Cats Does Countdown Festive Special, a show all about letters, numbers and conundrums. Did you know, for example, Christmas is a time when we use words and phrases we never use the rest of the year, like mistletoe, eggnog, and don't worry about Nan, she doesn't mean it, she was just brought up in a different time. 200,000 trees are cut down every year to make Christmas cards, which is why so many of them feature homeless robins. The word mistletoe means dung on a twig, whilst camel toe means your leggings are too tight. Right, let's get started. OK, let's meet tonight's players. First up, it's Sean Locke. Over the years, Sean's been described as hilarious, side-splitting and innocent due to diminished responsibility. And joining Sean tonight, it's Kathy Burke. Kathy recently appeared on a Gogglebox celebrity special, sitting round on a sofa, getting pissed, shouting at the telly, and then Gogglebox rang and asked her to do a celebrity special. Up against them this evening, it's John Richardson. Yes, John Richardson, hilarious, brilliant and confident are all nine-letter words John might get tonight. Did you just count up the letters in all those words?
I'm still working on it. Biting my tongue long enough about the fact that a robin is a hedge-dwelling bird and not a tree dweller. But...
And joining John tonight is David Bedil. David's just released his first children's book, The Parent Agency, about a nine-year-old who wants to swap his parents for more interesting people. Apparently, David got the idea from his nine-year-old.
No, that's true. I did. But I did get... I got a review for that kid's book on a kid's site, right? And a kid said, "This is the best book I've ever read in my life." And I thought, well, that sounds good, but he was nine. So it's a really short life, isn't it? That's like an assessment based on very... limited experience. It's like Nigel Farage saying that's the best reggae I've ever heard, isn't it?
I would say as well, if you've been on children's forums checking reviews for your book, just in general, I would delete your internet history.
That seems like pretty good advice. David, you've performed stand-up comedy at Wembley Arena. I believe you were the first comedian ever to perform at Wembley Arena. How was that?
It was good, although people say that Sean Locke was the first comedian to perform at Wembley.
Well, I believe he was, because he was your support actor.
No, he
technically,
wasn't.
Sean was me.
Yeah, yeah. No, you weren't. This is a comedy that Sean was our support, but he was in sketches, so he actually didn't come on till about the middle of the show. But people just think it's true.
Well,
now.
Let me just double check with Sean. Sean, is that true that you were the first?
Yes, I was first, yeah. What I liked about the story was that some journalists concocted it and it was fed back to me. Said, "You were the first." And it's quite a good bit of publicity, so I just went, "Yeah." So I went along with it for years.
Yeah.
And then it became the truth.
Yeah.
That's how history's written.
It's like people just think it's true. Like, it's the idea like that actually is your hair colour.
Dave's hair is like before and yours is after. Just for men.
Sean, what are your hopes and dreams for 2015?
One of the things I would like to happen next year is that I'd like them to convert all the Wetherspoons back into their original purpose, either banks, libraries, post offices. Because I think they'd have more atmosphere. And also, I think, personally, I'd like to be more in tune with other people's feelings, so that I can pinpoint their weaknesses and go for them more effectively when I need to.
Excellent.
It's a lovely sentiment, isn't it?
Excellent plan for 2015. John, earlier this year, you were voted the Sun's kookiest crush.
Yes. I've been in a few of those polls, and the word is different each year. It's like nerd crush, geek crush, crush I'd rather kill myself than admit to in public. Kooky is actually the one I hate the most, because kooky is how you describe people who think a hat is the same as a personality.
I've always thought of you as kooky.
Yeah, Kooky John. Is what
kooky
John. You shout at you. Kooky John!
Jimmy, yeah. You'll know this is true, because I've probably told you, but I was once voted in 2006 the world's sixth sexiest Jew. I was. And I was very flattered till I discovered the number five slot had gone to Sir Alan Sugar. It's true. Number five slot went to Sir Alan Sugar. It was a UK poll. I don't think the UK public have heard of that many Jews. I think number seven might have been Hitler.
Now, John, what else can you do? I mean, you're very good at Countdown. What else can you do in 30 seconds?
Not that, actually. I reckon I could count to 100 in 30 seconds.
Right, OK. It's not much of a challenge, but let's... I mean, we've got plenty of time, why not?
Really? This is going to happen?
Well, I'm with you. I don't know if you've just switched over from the Formula One. Strap in, because this is wild. Can I just check in with our maths expert, Rachel? Are there numbers up to 100?
Yeah.
OK, good. You ready, John? Your time starts now.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, 58, 59, 60, 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 68, 69, 70, 71, 72, 73, 74, 75, 78, 77, 76, 79, 80, 81, 82, 83, 84, 85, 86, 87, 88, 89, 100. Really fucking embarrassed about how serious I was. I really wanted that in a way that I hate about myself. When the show ends, I'm going to try that again upstairs. That is the pathetic truth that is my existence.
If you're watching at home and you're lonely, maybe you could count to 130 seconds. Now, Kathy, you've played Countdown before. Do you think you're going to do better this time? I mean, I'm not saying you did badly last time.
Well, we won last time. You can't do any better than winning, can you? No. So we won last time.
And she won with me, so that's quite an achievement.
Well, we say that, but I think, yeah.
You basically won on your own, but Sean was there.
He was there.
It's like you've won the Grand National on a penguin when you went there.
Kathy, if you had to describe your opponents this evening in three words, what would you choose?
Grey, beardy, and kooky.
Grey and beardy doesn't mind, but kooky's livid.
I think I was beardy and kooky, was I? Or was I just kooky?
You got a little bit of grey at the top there.
What the?
Just a little bit.
I think Jimmy can help me with that. I think it's going to be fine.
Let's just help yourself.
Imagine you coming out of the sales, you know, Black Friday or whatever, it was about Black Monday, they had all the fights, and you just punching people in the face with a big box of Just For Men. Going, bang! Bang!
David, did you bring a mascot this evening?
Yeah, I did, actually. This is it. This is a picture. It's really therapy more than it is a mascot. But it's a picture of me and my brothers at my primary school at a fancy dress day. And I'll just tell you, my brother there, Ivor, he is the ace of clubs. My younger brother, Dan, he's a detective. And me, I'm Miss World.
You went as Miss World?
I went as Miss World. It's 1973, so they did look like this. And when I look at this now, I don't understand what happened.
OK, so, John, have you got a mascot today?
It's not so much a mascot as an ongoing incentive. It's important to have statistics, so I've brought along... This is how I've got on at games so far this Christmas. Just talk you through some of what's happened here. Richardson family Christmas. Boggle, you can see there, played 6-1-3, lost 3. strip poker, that was me on my own towards the end.
Sorry, why is that a bag of drugs hanging on your statistics board?
This is the sand from the sand timer for Boggle, which was broken during an incident over whether or not the word berm existed. My sister won the argument because the word berm exists, but I won the argument because I broke the game. If you've got a bit of time, I can actually talk you through Boxing Day as well.
What's that one? Who stayed quietest the longest?
Oh, my mum suggested a game of who can stay quiet the longest. We played it. I lost. Shit game. So anyway, I shall be updating this with my countdown stats at the end of the day.
Okay, Kathy, have you got a mask on?
My dad liked Christmas, so I've got that. Fire humbug hat. Just put that on like that.
Fire humbug.
Yeah. A mouse mat. I thought that was rather countdown-ish. Got bar humbug on that as well. The problem with this is that maths. Is it, Rachel?
It's symbols.
Symbols.
Doesn't
not maths,
mean, doesn't so. Mean anything.
Does it not?
No.
Well, a lot of maths falls into that category.
You're not supposed to look like somebody in a Christmas hat if you turn it
is
to
it?
The side.
Like that.
Oh, yeah, it's like a grumpy Santa. He's got a little bobble on his hat.
Oh, yeah. Now I can see it. Now I know what it is.
It's a lot more fun. It's a lot more fun than you realise, isn't it?
I really had no idea.
Are you not? You're not a big Christmas person?
No, I don't like it at all. It's full of shit.
So what do you do on Christmas? What's your...
Nothing. I don't do nothing. I don't see no one. I don't answer the door.
Do you have, like, Christmas dinner, though?
No, I don't like Christmas dinner. I hate mince pies, I hate Christmas cake, I hate cloves, I hate cinnamon, nutmeg, all that shit.
So your house at Christmas is just you in the nude wandering around not eating turkey.
I'm in. Thing about being what naked.
You said I don't like clothes.
Cloves. Cloves.
Oh, cloves. Sean, have you got a mascot?
I've got a mascot so much. I've got a solution to a Christmas problem.
Oh, excellent.
One of the things, obviously, people fight over is the remote control. The other, of course, is control of the chocolates. I've come up with a solution here where one person can dish out chocolates to the various, you know, guests. Whoa! Oh, sorry.
Thank you. It's not very accurate.
I mean, it still needs a bit of work. It's got to go back to that. Branded it. There's Quality Street. I've come up with it. Inequality Street. And each chocolate has a theme from either the sort of the wealthy side of the street or the sort of poorer, more left-wing side.
So what's David eating now?
It's horrible.
David's having a Gary Barlow, which is you know, I've tried to make as bland a chocolate as possible. It's actually porridge-flavoured chocolate. That was the blandest chocolate. Then there's the Danny Dyer chocolate, which you can try, which is, you think it's going to be hard, but turns out it's not.
OK, over in Dictionary Corner, it's Alex Horn in the Horn section. Now, you're genuinely an ex-proper countdown champion. Have you got any tips for our players this evening?
Well, so when I did it, Des O'Connor was in your seat.
OK.
Before we started, Des looked at me. I remember that he sort of leaned into me and he said, Alex, no matter what happens tonight, he genuinely said this, he said, whatever happens tonight, if you get an eight-letter word or a seven-letter word or if you get a nine-letter word or if you get a four-letter word or a six-letter word or a five-letter word or a three-letter word or two, or even if you just say one of the letters, just don't worry about it. He said, don't worry about it, because, you know, at the end of this, at some point, we're all going to die and it doesn't mean anything.
Now it's Christmas. Obviously, it's Christmas. Mm. I was wondering if you could play us something sort of a bit Christmassy, the horn section.
Yes, we could sing a
carol. Oh, terrific! I would love that.
I've got one of these. Okay, here we go. This is for you, Jimmy. A B C D E F G H I J K M N O P Q R S T U V W X Y Z. No end.
And with Alex, of course, is Susie Dent. Of course, late in the afternoon on Christmas Day, Susie's family have to put up with a visit from Nana, or Carol Vorderman, as she prefers to call her. So, Susie, can I ask, every year, sort of at the end of the year, they do sort of a word of the year, and in 2014, it was photobomb. Do you think good choice or not, Susie? You're the expert.
OK, I can see I've been set up here, cos I found this under my desk when I came in. And a little bit earlier, I sneaked down to the studio to read the dictionary, as I do.
Genuinely, she's not a lot of fun.
And now I understand why this was left, cos, yes, photobombing. You might recognise the person.
So, yeah, I mean, that's...
That's the photo bomber.
Nice. OK. And in charge of the numbers, it's Rachel Riley. Rachel's got a first in quantum mechanics from Oxford University, and now she does the numbers on Countdown. It's like using the Large Hadron Collider to heat up soup. Rachel, you hosted a show recently about improving your memory. Have you got any tips for us on how we could improve our memories?
Yeah, so the visual memory is a lot stronger than any other kind of memory. So if you wanted to remember someone's name, say Jimmy, for example,
right,
you could think of something memorable to you. So I'd go maybe Jimmy Riddle, Cockney rhyming slang. So imagine you having a wee, and then you imagine something really prominent about their face that stands out. So you look a little bit like a vampire.
I'm not sure we can all agree on that.
So you could be dressed up as a vampire, having a wee, and then I'd remember your name.
I think what you're having there is a sexual fantasy.
Doesn't work with everyone, cos Kathy Burke. Burke's a really rude word in Cockney rhyming slang, so you shouldn't go there.
Is it?
Berkeley Hunt.
Oh, is that what it's from?
Yeah.
Ah. And so, what does that rhyme with?
OK, Rachel, you recently hosted a show about improving your memory. Have you got any tips on how we could improve our memory? OK, tonight, the prize the teams will be competing for is this, His and Hers Countdown Swimwear. Incredible arse on that bloke. OK, let's count down, everyone. Time for the first game. John and David, you get the first pick of the letters.
OK, vowel, please, Rachel.
Thank you, David. Start with O.
Consonant.
S.
And another consonant.
G.
And a vowel.
E.
And a consonant.
J.
And another consonant.
S.
Ooh. And a vowel.
Another O.
I never understand what to do in this bit.
Yeah, it's coming across.
Consonant.
C.
What should I do now?
I think start again.
I don't know, consonant.
Yeah.
Last one. N.
N.
And so, for the very first time today, here is the countdown clock. What have you got?
Well, I've got a David? Shit four-letter word now, cos you were chucking things at me.
So you got four letters? Well, John, what have you got?
Let's try an eight.
Oh.
Ooh. Sean, what have you got?
Six.
Kathy?
Five.
OK, sorry. David, let's hear your four-letter word that you managed to write down. Well done.
Jogs.
Kathy, you're five?
Quite Christmassy. Goose.
Goose. Sean, you're six?
Gooses.
Oh.
John, you're eight?
It's the most festive word of all. It's how you measure a good Christmas pudding.
Oh, right.
By its googeness.
Yes, googeness.
G-O-O-J-N-E-S-S.
If it was there, it would be just above gook, which is a sloppy, wet substance, and ghoulies. And it's not...
You don't want to get in between those two. No wonder it isn't there.
It's not there. Sorry, John. Gooses, on the other hand, is.
OK, what? 6 points to Sean.
Hey.
Let's go over to Dictionary Corner and see what they could have had. Alex, Susie, what could they have done?
I found Jesus for Christmas. But during it, Susie wrote down cojones. But is that not Spanish? Is that fine?
It is. A man's testicles. Or guts.
OK, so at the end of that, Sean and Cathy are in the lead with 6.
Yeah.
On to our first numbers round. OK, Sean and Cathy, your turn to pick the numbers.
OK.
Oh, here we go. Oh, I hate this bit. I can't be bothered with this.
Sorry, Rachel. You've got your symbols and everything.
No, I know, Rachel, but I really can't be bothered.
One from the top and 4, as you fancy.
Do you want another one?
5, then, all right.
Right, they are 5, 8, 1, 3, 4, and the big one, 50. And the target, 779.
OK, and your time starts now.
I think I've got it.
You think you've got it? David, have you got it?
No, of course not. 759.
Cathy, what have you got?
810.
Sean?
779.5.
OK.
No, I got nowhere near it.
OK. John, how did you do it?
50 plus 8 over 4. 50.
OK, could you pause a bit more as you're saying this, almost as if you're making up as you go along?
52.
Multiplied by 5 times 3.
Yeah, times 5 times 3, 15 for 780.
And take away the 1.
Well done, 779.
10 points for John. The scores at the moment, Sean and Cathy have 6 points, John and David have 10, and here is your teaser. The words are dated elf, and the clue is he went down on me. That's dated elf, he went down on me. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were dated elf, the clue was he went down on me. It was, of course, deflated. So, John and David are in the lead. OK, time to mix things up a little bit. They've been playing in team so far, but this game is just for Cathy and John. So, Cathy, your turn to choose the letters.
Oh, hello.
Hello.
Vowel, please.
Thank you, Cathy. E.
And a vowel, please.
A.
And a vowel.
A vowel.
E. And I'll have a consonant, please.
K.
Consonant.
D.
I can never say that word.
I'd write them, just a little tip, I'd write them down.
Consonant.
P.
And a vowel.
Another A.
And a consonant.
R.
Ah, so it's going to be a good one. Okay. And a vowel, please.
And the last one.
Right.
O.
A, K.
OK, and your time starts now.
Six.
John?
I'll try a 7.
OK, Cathy, what's your 6?
Parked.
OK, what's your 7, John?
Pokered.
Oh.
As in what?
We had a game of poker. We all pokered together.
I'm hoping, but disappointed, cos it's not in.
Something wrong with that dictionary you've got
over
there. Well, 6 points to Cathy.
Hooray!
For that, Cathy, you deserve another chocolate. That's a Farage, that is. That's the on the right side of the street. That's the Farage chocolates, based on a wartime recipe. It's disgusting.
Alex, could they have done any better?
Well, I got area code for 8, but you need to have a K instead of the C and an extra E and also area code in the word.
Yeah, but otherwise, I mean, that's brilliant.
Yeah.
No, I put no poker, but you could have had porked.
I did get porked, but out of respect for David, who is Jewish, I didn't say it.
What does porked mean?
Sometimes when a mummy and a daddy love each other very much.
Yeah, but I think that's not the one in the dictionary. What actually is it?
No, that one is in the dictionary.
Oh.
It says vulgar slang.
What's the non-slang meaning? Is there a non-slang?
Well, there's porking out. You can pork out on...
Oh, OK.
You wouldn't, but you could.
Yeah, I would. I'm not that Jewish. My girlfriend, this is true, my girlfriend, she is Mummy Pig in Peppa Pig, which is complicated for a Jewish bloke.
OK, so at the end of that, John and David have 10. Sean and Cathy are in the lead with 12. Right, now time for Sean and David to go head-to-head. David, your turn to pick the numbers.
Oh, is it numbers? Oh, I really hate this. I'll have 2 from the top.
OK. And 4 little.
Yes.
Thank you, David. Right, for this round, the small ones are 3, 1, 2, and 5, and the large ones 25 and 50. And the target, 425.
Well, Alex, you've got the band with you. Would you mind getting the horn section to play the countdown music?
Fine. What style?
Maybe something Christmassy?
Fine. I've got a little frog and sleigh bells.
OK, so your time starts in...
3, 4.
Now. It was 425. Sean, what did you get?
I got 425.
David, how did you do?
I got 425 as well. I think my woo was slightly more sarcastic.
How did you do it, David?
Right, OK. 50 times 2 is 100.
Oh, well done.
Yeah. then 3 plus 1 is 4.
Oh.
Multiply those together and add 25.
Hey, 45.
Sean, how did you do it?
I did 3 and 5 is 8.
Yep.
Times 50 is 400 plus 25.
Well done.
10 points for both teams. Fine work. OK, time now to go across to Dictionary Corner. Alex, what have you got for us?
I've got, because it's Christmas, quite a sexy modern dance for you. So I'm going to approach you and the trumpeter's going to stand over there.
Okay. Wow, OK. What a lovely Christmas treat for us.
OK, I'm starting here.
When I dance in the hacienda and the boys, they say, cool, soy buena. They all want me, they can't have me, so they all come and dance beside me. Move with me, chat with me, and if I like, I take you home with me. Dale a tu cuerpo, alegría, macarena. Con tu cuerpo, espa de alegría, y cos buena. Dale a tu cuerpo, alegría, macarena. Hey, Macarena.
No!
Don't you worry about my boyfriend. No. The boy whose name's Victorino. I don't want him. Couldn't stand him. He was no good, so I. Dale a tu cuerpo, alegría, Macarena. Tu cuerpo es de alegría, y cos buena. Dale a tu cuerpo, alegría, Macarena. Hey, Macarena. Dale a tu cuerpo, alegría, Macarena. Tu cuerpo es de alegría, y cos buena. Dale a tu cuerpo, alegría.
OK. The scores at the moment, John and David have 20, Sean and Cathy have 22. They're in the lead. And here is your teaser. The words are grand fart and the clue is smells lovely. That's grand fart smells lovely. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were grand fart, the clue was smells lovely. It was, of course, fragrant. OK, before we go on, he doesn't work here anymore, but he's turned up anyway. So to perform the Christmas Nativity, please welcome Joe Wilkinson. Is that your nativity play?
I'll be honest with you, Jimmy, there's been a couple of fuck-ups. For a start, the girls were meant to come on from that side. Actually, go on, girls, head off. Go on.
Joe, what happened?
Oh, two happened, Jimmy. I was away and it was left up to my half-brother Fabio to organise everything. And as you know, he's a fucking idiot. For a start, he didn't know what a donkey was. And rather than ask, he guessed! Not a donkey, mate, it's a camel! Oh, he didn't know what a manger was, so what did he do? He bought an immersion heater. He didn't know what gold, frankincense and myrrh was, so what did you do? You bought the family fortune board game. It was actually when he redeemed himself. That's an absolutely cracking show, not like this bag of shit. And then the bit that annoys me most is instead of getting a dolly to play the baby Jesus, he hired Pat Sharp.
I really like Countdown, so I was wondering if I could do on the show, maybe.
Fuck that, get him out of here. Not having him ruining Christmas, he does it every year. Get him out of here! Let's play Countdown!
OK, on with the game. John and David, your turn to choose the letters.
You want to do it this time?
Yes.
Joe, what have you got there?
I've just got to quickly make Susie's Christmas present. I'm going to quickly carve a statue of myself. Got some lager.
Joe, I don't want to be a stickler, but is it a good idea to drink heavily while using a chainsaw?
It's fine, it's Christmas lager, it's just Baileys. Carry on, I just got to quickly...
OK, Val.
I'm intrigued to see whether they've let him have an actual chainsaw. Hey.
I can't believe they give him lager.
A consonant, please.
Oh, it's just knackered.
And a vowel, please.
You.
A consonant, please. Let's hope for an S. A vowel, please.
E.
A consonant, please.
T.
You're just going to have a bit of wood.
A consonant, please.
N.
A vowel, please.
I.
And a consonant, please.
And the last one, L.
OK, and your time starts now. John, how many letters?
Seven.
You sound very confident.
Well, I mean, I think I've got a nine, but then that's happened so often that I've just lost all confidence, to be honest.
Go for it. Well, imagine how brilliant it'll be when you get it. It'll be incredible.
I'm going to try a nine, then.
Yes! Try a nine! David, what have you got?
I think I've got a seven, but I'm not sure.
Well, I'm not sure either.
No.
I wouldn't risk it with you.
Yeah, I'm very much basing it on the fact that there was a Spanish word earlier on.
Okay, let's definitely go with that. Kathy, what have you got?
I think I've got a seven. I think.
Sean, what have you got?
I've got a pissy six.
What's your six? What's your pissy six?
Retain.
Kathy, your seven?
Well, it's a bit embarrassing. I don't know whether it's in a word, whether I've spelled it right. Laureate.
Oh, how you spelling it?
Well, that's a good one.
L-A-U-R-I-E-T. Ooh. As in poet laureate. How do you spell that, Susie?
Well, the pronunciation is spelled exactly as you
spell it. Are you allowed to spell things phonetically on Countdown or not?
Well, it's a Christmas special. Come on, let's do it.
Don't patronise me, Susie. Fucking hell.
David, what was your seven?
It's, I'm a bit embarrassed. It's naturel, as in natural in French. Naturel. N-A-T-U-R-E-L.
If you could find the AU, I'd put in a hyphen.
That's a different word.
9 points.
27 points.
John, you're nine.
Oh, this is going to really upset me because I looked at Susie when I said I think I've got a nine and she nodded as if to say there is a nine there and I think I haven't got it. Which is going to piss me off all the more, but my nine is unreliant.
Ooh. Unreliant.
Yes.
Unreliant. If we've got a nine, we better go mental.
No.
Drum roll, please.
Just look
unreliant.
Yep.
The proper Countdown.
I'm not happy about it, but it deserves a double chocolate salute.
That is possibly.
It doesn't sound like you'd ever use it, is it? Unreliant.
Unreliant. Is it really there? Or did you just write it in just now?
Moving on.
If that's not real.
I don't want to shit on our own chances, but I saw her writing it in.
Susie Dent first discovered she had Munchausen's.
Is that a nine-letter word or
no,
not?
No, of course it's not.
Sean, you get 6 points. Sorry, I've got to say, Nick, you take it back. Your show's better than our show.
Six. Really pleased with the say six.
Is there
that's
anything...
a nine!
Susie, what could they have had?
Well, Sean had...
Sorry, Alex, what could they have had? I'm going to ask someone I could trust.
It's a nice Christmassy word, internal.
OK, the scores at the moment, John and David have 20, Sean and Cathy have 28. OK, time to go once again to Dictionary Corner. Alex, what have you got for us this time?
Well, Jimmy, I've got a special guest for you. Because it's Christmas, we thought we'd bring along a man who's synonymous with Christmas, with his little smiley face and his red and white and black outfit, and he's quite... He's actually quite a commercial figure, but we love him. I think everyone loves him, so please welcome Henry. It's Henry. Here he is. It's Henry. Here he is. It's our... Christmas Henry. There you go, Henry. There you go. Yeah. It's a rare... Drink it in. It's charming and chilling as an image. And what he's done, he's prepared a song for you, Henry. It's... You're not... Sorry. He's prepared a song for you, Jimmy.
We do look alike.
Yeah.
Similar hair, Henry.
Jimmy, can I just say also, your laugh, just by the way, we think it's an F-sharp. Can you, have you got it there? Just... It's F-sharp.
Carpets, rugs and tiling. My enormous nose is less of a nose, it's more of a corrugated dust-sucking hose.
Dust-sucking hose!
But if you want a spotless carpet, stronger cleaners are on the market. Mike, Dyson, Dustbuster Douglas, Van Hoover Field and Electrolux Lewis.
I can give a toss, I'm Henry Hoover. Spin me round, I'm quite some mover. Force my nose in your dirty little carpet. I couldn't give a toss, it's quite pathetic. Henry Hoover! Henry Hoover!
Here's your final teaser. The words are fun gifts, and the clue is you can put it in your bird. That's fun gifts, you can put it in your bird. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser. The words were fun gifts. The clue was you can put it in your bird. It was, of course, stuffing. OK, on to our final letters game. Kathy, Sean, your turn to pick the letters.
All right.
Rachel, would you like to pull my cracker?
Sure.
It's one I made myself, actually. All my crackers have pictures of wheelie bins on fire. Selling them after, 200 quid.
Can I have a bowel, please?
Sure. Joe?
No, I'm not. Can't be honest. I'm on holiday.
All right, E, fine.
Consonant, please.
V.
Consonant.
M.
Another consonant.
T.
Have a consonant, please.
R.
Vowel, then, please.
I.
Another vowel, please.
E. Thanks, Joe.
No, I'm happy to help.
Another E. I'll have another vowel, please.
Of course you will.
Thanks, Jess. A.
And a consonant.
And the last one. L.
Alex, as it's the last letters game, could you do us some special music for the clock?
Well, Richard Whiteley used to actually sing the lyrics to Countdown over the clock, so I'll sing the original lyrics.
Okay, fine. So your time starts in...
Okay, everyone, the clock's begun, let's have lots of fun.
Time to make a word.
We believe in you, you know what to do, make our dreams come true.
Time to make a word.
Words have gotta be in the dictionary, Dent is next to me.
Time to make a word.
20 seconds left, now there's slightly less, maybe have a guess.
Time to make a word.
You can do this, mate, really concentrate, try to get an 8.
Time to make a word.
Your names are not allowed, try to use a vowel, 7 seconds now.
I have got a 9-letter word.
That's a secret, now it's the time for the
What have you got, Kathy?
What have I got? 1, 2, 3, 4, 7.
7. Terrific. Sean, what have you got?
7.
John?
8.
David?
I think I've got a 9.
Well, let's not get overexcited. Sean, what have you got?
I've got Prevail.
You've got Prevail. Are you eating a pork pie?
Easter egg, John.
Easter
egg. An Easter egg.
Anyone else?
Yeah.
This is a good game.
Oh. Yeah, get him, Sean, get him. Damn. Well played, Joe. Well played.
I tried to save you.
Really?
The footage will show that I leapt in front of that bullet.
Kathy, you're 7?
Yeah, vampire.
Vampire. Excellent work. John, you're 8.
Well, we're at an interesting point now, Jimmy, because David and I have declared the same word. One of us is an 8 and one of us is a 9.
go on, John. What do you think the word is?
Primeval.
That's the word I've got, too.
Primeval.
I thought it had... 9 letters.
An extra E in the middle.
Actually,
primeval.
Susie, is that the right spelling of primeval?
Yep, so that 8's brilliant.
OK, 8 points to John's team. OK, so Sean and Kathy have 28, John and David have 28. Ooh. That means it is level pegging. So it's time for today's crucial countdown conundrum.
Anti.
Tea.
Oh.
Anti-bedsan.
Start the clock. John.
Abstained.
Let's see if you were right.
Well done.
So the final scores are Sean and Cathy have 28, but tonight's winners are John and David with 38 points. Congratulations, you're now the proud owners of His and Hers Countdown Swimwear. Thanks to all our panelists, our wonderful studio audience, and to all of you for watching at home. We'll be back for a new series in January. Good night.